Oh, I don't like this at all, guys. I really don't like this. With my diamond sword in my hand, I hope to be safe to some degree. I welcome you all to a brand new video. Oh, first and foremost, guys, the boogeyman, this investigation has gone nuts. Absolutely insane. It seems to be unfolding a message that I don't even know what's really going on. But all your input, all the theories that you guys have also posted alongside this, I want to thank you all for that. And I want to say, if you haven't seen the previous episode, pause this, go watch it. There's the whole playlist on my channel. Catch yourself up, man. Stop being silly. And I will say this, if you're not a subscriber of the channel when you're new here, are you good, dude? Don't get left behind. Join us, man. Team ONG's on the rise. So with that aside, subscribe, enable post notifications by ringing the bell. I'm gonna get to go ding. Enabling post notifications, really, really important, guys. Now we return. Now you may be like, oh, ONG, why is there a ring of fire right in front of you that looks really creepy and everything of relating sword? That is what we got to talk about in today's episode. We got to talk about a lot of stuff. A lot of stuff. So strap in, grab whatever you may need, and prepare yourself for another scary Minecraft video. We have one carrot here, which I'm about to devour in honor of all the bunnies here. Dude, where do we even begin with this video, guys? Okay, like, I was like, I gotta get back in this investigation, right? I took a little brief intermission. Today, I was like, look, I gotta face my fears. I gotta brace myself again. And I have to go right back, guys, and I have to investigate some more of this boogeyman. Crazy, like, I don't even know what's going on at this point, guys. I really don't even know what's going on. All I'll say is I'm glad you guys are here with me as well, helping me alongside this investigation, trying to figure this out, because this is no joke, guys. And all I seem to hear now is the crackling of this fire. Like, this has been something that we've been trying to figure out. We haven't even been to the village in so long of time, guys. I hope the village is safe. I hope all the villagers are doing well. I hope Boogeyman is not there cursing them to any degree. We made an iron golem. We set off on a journey. I think the village is safe. I think the villagers are safe as well. A lot of you guys have been concerned. You're like, OMG, make sure the village is okay, OMG. I think it's okay, guys. I think it's going to be all right, all right? We've been in the village for a while. We've upgraded it. We put an iron golem there. We've done everything in relation that could potentially aid protection in the village, guys, so I think we're gonna be okay. Fingers crossed. We got a lot that we need to investigate here, guys. I know there's so much we need to do. There's still a lot of stuff that we need to investigate around the village, like region, just from Boogeyman's actual home that we found, a lot of the shrine that was going on inside the village. There was a Boogeyman shrine for what? I don't even know. And now we have like a totem of like ritualistic purposes, which appears, and well, that is what we're talking about today. In the last episode, you guys left a lot of feedback, and I always say this, guys, we are the freaking, we're the most flippin' active channel, we have the most engagement rate, hands down. You guys pulled through with your own opinions, your thoughts on this investigation, what's going on, where we should go, and dude, I love it. Like, I love the fact that we're creating an awesome community here and trying to figure this out. This stuff is no joke. So, in the last episode, in review, if you guys didn't happen to see it, maybe I could play a clip now. If the clip didn't roll, then either I was too lazy with editing or I just forgot. But if you've seen that clip, it is beyond eerie. It is beyond the level of no return. It is something. That's the last thing I needed. That's the last thing I needed was rain. Rain just makes the eerie vibes 10 times worse, guys. What are we doing in today's episode first, most importantly? We're gonna be looking in the chest. Guys, we're about to go through this fire and look in this chest in today's episode. But we need to review a little bit on what happened prior and some of the theories you guys have posted. It was obvious. Boogeyman's disciple appeared. We hadn't seen him in forever. Boogeyman's disciple is the one that has clearly been doing all this stuff and working for Boogeyman. Now, we do know Boogeyman likes to get hands-on as well, because we've spotted Boogeyman, like in the earlier episodes, we spotted him in the village running around with what appeared to be like a Steve head in his hand. Later down the line, Steve heads and redstone blood starts appearing all throughout the village. Boogeyman was trying to send us a warning, but it's not just him. It seems he has a disciple which does a lot of his dirty work for him. That adds a lot of stuff, and it seems his disciple actually worships him to an odd degree. And the reason I say that is, obviously in the last episode, the disciple was doing some type of ritual based around this ring of fire. A very weird ritual, unlike anything I've ever seen. He was legitimately doing a ritual. Now, guys, we've done Minecraft rituals in the past, but nothing like that, guys. Nothing like that. That was very demented. Guys, like, he this weird thing, he went up, down, like, 3, 4, 5 times, 6 times, probably, he'd be in that specific number. Then he walked around this circle. Like, he just ran around the circle, which I don't even want to do it, guys, because I don't even want to replicate anything in regards to that ritual. But he just walked around. He ran around it, like, multiple times like that. And then in the cross, he, like, went back and forth in the cross fire. And no, guys. He wasn't taking damage from the fire. Oh. No, guys. This is bad. This is really, really bad. This means Boogeyman's disciple is immune to fire. Which makes sense. I mean, Boogeyman did reside in the nether. We did find the 3 flaming crosses in the nether, which signifies that they are not afraid of fire whatsoever, guys. They're immune to fire. We need to become immune to fire, guys. We're going to have fire resistance, like armor or something. I cleaned up my inventory, by the way. But we're going to have fire resistant armor. Wow. We now know one of the traits of Boogeyman and Boogeyman's disciple. They're immune to fire. Because think about it, any regular normal Minecraft player or mob cannot get near this fire unless, of course, we go into creative, but we can't go into the actual fire. And a lot of times, with this type of specifics, like in regards to ritualistic things, things have to be aligned perfectly, guys. We have to keep in mind about that, right? Everything you do has to be aligned perfectly. So, be it the case, maybe the ritual wouldn't work if we wasn't in survival. Something to think about. There's a lot of stuff to think about. Okay, guys, I'm trying to figure out how I'm going to get there. I need food. Let me just give myself some beef. I'm in the ring of fire right now, guys. All right, we're going to have to take some... Okay, that wasn't bad. I made it. Soon it will appear. I think we got that wrong. I think we got that very wrong. You may be like, what do you mean, Owen, you got it wrong? I thought it said soon it will all end. That's what we all translated it because we couldn't see. We wasn't right next to it. We didn't even know what the signs truly said. This says soon it will appear. You know, guys, just being in the same spot that the disciple was when he was doing the ritualistic ways of perhaps worshiping Boogeyman, I feel very wrong about being here. I feel like I'm doing something very unjustified, something very wrongful. I don't like this feeling, guys. I feel like I'm doing something very evil just by standing here. Do you guys get that feeling? Oh, I don't like this at all, guys. I really don't like this. And I didn't like that at all. I did not like that at all when I just saw, guys. I did not like that at all. No, guys. First off, the outline in that chest looked really creepy. There was like rotten flesh. Other very demented like stuff in there, guys. And of course, lying in the middle was a book. Another book. Another freaking book, guys. And there's no telling what that is going to say. If you don't know, guys, we've accumulated 3 books from this series of events. Unfortunate events. The Power of 6, The Cry for Help, The Scripture, all books are for telling a very interesting agenda that I am not sure if I want to stand by or I have any, if I want to have any relation to whatsoever. This is getting bad, guys. This is getting more and more, like, the deeper we go, the worse that this is getting. It's getting out of hand. But we have to conclude today's episode here, guys. I'm so, so sorry. I'm limited on time. I want to do more. I really do. If you guys want to see this continue, you guys want to see me open up that chest, grab that book, and read that book, let me know in the comment section below. This could be getting insane. Guys, thanks so much. Holy cow, guys. I can say this. The series, the channel, it's about to explode. Strap in. Share the videos with friends, family. We need all the investigators, all the help that we can get. It's not about just growing the channel. It's about growing and helping, you know, figure these myths out, everything in relation to Minecraft. Thanks so much, guys. As always, I love you all, and I will see you all in the next one.